Good morning, students. We will continue our next point, that is the separation of soluble solids from a mixture. See, before this point, we discuss about how to separate the insoluble solids from a liquid. Okay, for that, the two methods we are using, that is the sedimentation and decantation as well as filtration. Okay, we learn that all the properties in detail with the help of practical. Okay, so now next point, that is the separation of soluble solids from a mixture, means if it is the soluble solid is present in the mixture, then how to separate that. Okay, for example, see, first one it is there, that is the evaporation. See, now evaporation, everyone know this method, what exactly, what just we have to give the heat, and after that, when that water is start boiling and that water is converted into gaseous state, that is only known as a evaporation. Okay, now here, see, one picture is shown here in this activity. In this picture, it shows that how the evaporation occurs, and in daily at your home also, you can just observe how your mother is cooking food and all. In that also, most of the time the evaporation happen. Okay, so what is the definition of evaporation? See, the process of changing of a liquid. See, the process of changing of a liquid into its vapor by heating is called as evaporation. Now, for example, salt and water. One mixture is there. Now, salt is soluble in water. Okay, just stir it. After 5 minutes or within 2 or 3 minutes, it will be totally invisible in water. Means what? It is soluble in water. Okay. Now, that mixture you have to separate it. Then now it is soluble, it is not insoluble. If it is insoluble, then we can use the method, that is sedimentation, decantation and filtration. But now in this case, in this example, salt and water, salt is soluble in water. Now how to separate this? So for that, we will use the evaporation method. Means what? Just take this mixture, okay, and heat it. After when if that water will start boiling, that water will convert into vapors. Now vapors means what? It will convert into a gaseous state. Vapors, you can say it is a steam also, okay? And the all water when evaporated, you will get the salt, okay? So you separated the salt from water. Understood this first method? Okay. Now this is the method to separate the soluble solids from a mixture. Now the next point, it is given in your textbook. See, here I given only one example, like that at least 5 examples you write, and related to this point, read textbooks. Just refer our ICSE board book also, and read points and whichever the important points you write down in your notebook. Okay, now the next point it is there, that is the separation of liquid from a mixture. Now here what we have to separate the liquid. See, in this method what we separated? The solid form. Means solid, now in this, salt and water. Which one is a solid? This salt is a solid. See, while evaporation process, that water is converted into vapor state, okay? This water we are not getting, it is already the evaporated. But what we got? Salt. So salt is what? It is in a solid state. But now, in this case, what we have to separate? Liquid. Okay? In this case, we have to separate the liquid. So how to get the liquid? For that also, some methods are there. So here the first method is there, that is the condensation. See, these words already you learn in 5th standard also. Okay, evaporation, condensation. But where to use that? Then this method we are using for the separating two substances, that you were not knowing. Okay, but now this condensation method is used to separate the liquid from a mixture. Now see, what is the definition of condensation? See, the process of changing vapor into its liquid. See, the process of changing vapors. Now in the evaporation, water started boiling, it will convert into a vapor state. that only vapors we have to convert it into a liquid state. Means that vapors convert into liquid state on cooling. How it is possible? It is possible on cooling. See, evaporation we are giving heat, then it convert into a vapor state, and that only vapors we are going to collect it in another beaker. See, here one picture is shown. In this picture the condensation shown here means what? See, we have to stop heat here and you just put on lid on that. See, at your home also, whenever your mother is a boiling water, just after some time you just keep on lid on that, and then you will see the small bubbles on that lid. Okay, that is the process of the condensation. Means we converted the vapors into a liquid state, and then that liquid you can collect in another container or another beaker. Okay, this process is known as a condensation, and this method is used to obtain a liquid from its solution. So this method we are using to obtain a liquid. Evaporation, in this method we are obtain a solid substance, whichever it is present in that, and in the condensation we will get the liquid. Okay, so do you understand this, both the methods, evaporation, when to use, and the condensation? Read points carefully, read your textbook again, okay, and write at least 2 or 3 examples of each method, where to use this method. Just think, just observe in your surrounding, you will get many examples. Okay, now the next point we will continue in our next lecture. Thank you.